Hello, this is Oksana from Alabama, your realtor with IXL. Check out this new program I purchased. Well, we realtors like to see houses, sell houses. We know our markets. Today we're gonna pretend I'm your realtor and you are my customer. Check out this kitchen. That's gonna be me and that's gonna be you. First of all, you have to be pre-approved before realtors run around with you showing houses. Malcolm Seals is a listing agent. This house in Carriage Hill subdivision is selling for $235,000. Check out this walkway. Saga palms. Brick exterior and vinyl siding. Two-car garage where you can put all your junk and still park cars outside, of course. Yeah, I can't wait to check it out with you. I love open houses. Check out the column. All right, brick. Brick. All right. Now the door can be fixed, restained. Okay, let's see. A hall has a brick flooring. Many older houses in Alabama have brick flooring. You have your split plan where four bedrooms are upstairs. And some den family room downstairs. This is living room. That's my 11-year-old Ivan. He is sick of me dragging him everywhere. Check out the Christmas tree. I don't know how you feel about it, but I see many people in Alabama keep Christmas tree all year round. They just change decorations for each holiday: Easter, Mardi Gras, Christmas. The realtor who was holding open house, she made little gifts for all the visitors. Sherry put in the gifts a bottle of water and some candies. My son was very happy to get some candies. Table is nice, huh? Yeah. Well, that's a big window. It looks like it needs some work. You can put all your plants there, but I guess you need. Would be good to have tile there because you can never water plants in a perfect way. I see popcorn ceiling. It used to be in 80s and 90s and 70s. They would apply popcorn texture to the ceilings. That was to hide the imperfections between the sheetrock seams. It's more money to make smooth ceiling. To remove popcorn in a house like that to make smooth ceilings could cost you about $4,000. I know that because we've been in the remodeling business for a while. Because it's not about removing popcorn, it's about to make ceilings smooth after you did that. So we see dining area. It's kind of like open dining area and the living room. That's more detailed information about the house. It was built in 1975 and at 2,735 square feet. Yes, I know big towns like New York, Los Angeles that don't even have prices like that anymore for solid houses like that. Kitchen is pretty big. You can see while doing dishes what's out there. Yeah, let's check out what's out there. Oh, a cute teapot. Okay, bamboo. Okay, out there would be cars, whatever you have parked. Your backyard. Vodka, sangria, yeah. So you have enough space in this kitchen to put your vodka and sangria. Alright. See, cabinets don't look old. Cabinets look fine. This is not granite, this is like formica, but it looks like it's in a good condition. Electric stove. And my cute red purse, check it out. Okay, so some investors, when they remodel houses, they knock down that top cabinets. They just get rid of it, so the kitchen looks like bigger. Yeah, that's what would investor do if got that house in a poor condition. Oh, but that's not the case. Okay, let's see. So pretty much, I did a circle. I came from front door, made through living room. Yeah, carpet looks like needs replacement. So we're going downstairs. They have so garage, laundry room. They are downstairs. You can put little gate so dog or kid cannot run out or fall downstairs. Closet for your fur coats. Yeah, sometimes it gets cold in Mobile. Tile, wallpaper, black. Very cool here. I like it. Yeah, a little outdated, or we would call vintage. Vintage. I don't know if you bought this house, if you would keep that wallpaper. Looks like they had some leak and home improvements had to be done. So yeah. Yeah, you know, we can walk around and look for imperfections and well, we're not looking for imperfections, we're just looking at everything we can see. I don't know, a pocket door would work better there. Looks like they had a dog. Family room. Look how much space you have. You can invest in new carpet and new fresh paint. And the house is great because 2,700 square feet. If you would build a new one from Horton, you would probably spend about $360,000. Dollars. So let's see, this is bar and the sink. That our realtor I will introduce you later. You'll see the interview. Okay, washer and dryer, sink, cabinets. I think all cabinets used to be like that, but they replaced the kitchen ones. Pretty big yard, huh? So we came out from this family room, checking out a yard. Well, there is no pool, but plenty of space for your dog, playground. You see, they got trampoline. You can always actually ask the seller to leave you certain things like trampoline or furniture. That would be, of course, extra, but it's everything can be negotiated. Everything has a price, unless it's, you know, memories about family. I like those oak trees. They do look beautiful. Yes, the Tudor style house. Yeah, so it looks like one floor on one side and two floors from another side. Okay, this is a garage for your junk, of course. Seems like most people have their junk in the garage. Okay, let's check out upstairs. I can't wait. I took my son with me and he, first he was bored, but then he had energy to go upstairs and check out with me. You see the dark baseboards and the doors, real wooden doors. Some people like, you know, doors like that, solid wood. Bedroom number one, I would call it burgundy, because old burgundy carpet, it's got to go. I don't care if you like burgundy carpet, you've got to take it out. Okay, so pretty big room. You see, you can have a bedroom and an office in it. See if they could, you know, manage to have all that. I think it's good. Yeah. Stained doors, they could be restained if you want fresh look. This is like bluish carpet. Okay. Pretty big bedroom. When I see animals like this, I think about my son's allergies and mites. Okay. Yeah, I'm just showing you. I always show pluses and minuses of the house when I make a video. When I'm showing you the house in person, I'm not gonna tell you, oh, look at this problem or look at that problem. Because what's problem to me, it might not be a problem to you. You probably want to get something so you can redo to your own taste. But when I am making a video, I'm showing you, you know, what house has and if it has some work. So people who buy house after watching video tour like that, they would know, you know, that they would see that I didn't lie to them. But also, I strongly suggest don't ignore paying professional inspectors, because they will take pictures of all the problems. They will go to the roof, they will go climb into the attic, they will take pictures of everything, they will check every toilet, does it flush good, every faucet, does it leak. My son is cute, isn't he? So, pretty much, yes, when you're buying something after the video tour, you've got to have your inspection. And all realtors, we have information on the neighborhoods. If you're interested in some house, we can send you details, what's your neighbor's names, what kind of stores are nearby, the taxes, everything. I like the golden wall. I think it's kind of like unique, like the golden wall, you like queen, king and a queen. And they have this like gold color in this area. And vintage lamp. I wouldn't replace that, because it has some, you know, old time possess. Oh boy, yeah. And I was telling my son, you know, this look really cool, really cool. So, there is another bathroom gonna be there. This bathroom, very small, has a toilet, and there is a mirror over there. You're like sitting on the toilet and looking at yourself pooping. My son thought it was funny. So, yeah, you have a master bedroom upstairs. And there is another bathroom, check this out. Red and white. It doesn't have to be replaced, it looks fine to me. And look, everything is matching, you know. The tub, you can replace the tub, looks like they painted it before. Yeah, very interesting. A painted tub. I can't wait to share with you interview I took from realtor Sherry Berg. So please write a comment, thank me in it, send me a thumbs up, a smiley face, do something, ask a question, what kind of houses you want to see on my channel. Okay. Sherry, please tell us about yourself.
Awesome. Okay. I've lived in Alabama my entire life. I have lived in Mobile for the past 20 something years, I think 2001, so that tells you about since 1000, you know, to, but I've been in real estate since we came to Mobile. I started selling real estate on my own. Well, I would take a property and it was in bad shape, and I would put all my resources in there and my energy and my money and fix it up and dress it up really pretty and then put it on the market and sell it for money, profit. There you go, flipped houses. See, there
so
you go.
So without real estate license.
Mm-hmm.
So please tell us what you love about Mobile.
Oh my goodness. Anybody that comes to Mobile is going to love the climate and love being so close to the beaches, because in our country it's so big, but not very many people get to the beaches. It's a very big treat. But to live here all the time and to be able to go anytime you want to go to the beach and seafood, the food. I know Russians have good food, but we have amazing food on the coast. So the food here, the pace is slower, just a little bit slower than the rest of the country. Everybody in the other parts of the country are in a big hurry. Here, we usually don't get away from our home about 10 to 20 minutes. I mean, we stay slow and low. I like the lifestyle.
Have you lived in other states?
I have never lived in another state. I have lived all over Alabama. I have lived in the center. I've lived at the top. I've lived here at the bottom. Uh-huh. But I have traveled to most all the other states and have relatives that live in Chicago, New York, California. So all over the country.
What's your favorite food?
Food. Seafood. It's going to have to be seafood. And if I'm going to eat seafood in Mobile, I'm going to give a plug for Winsoles. They're the best seafood.
Oh, I love it. what do you think about hurricanes?
Yeah, well, hurricanes are about as dangerous as snakes here. I mean, it's mostly, how's the word? Fiction. I mean, the scary part, because we do know ahead of time that a hurricane is coming. So you have days and days and days to get ready. And then usually if it does come and wipe everything out, everyone's back together. It unifies everyone. We work together. We help our neighbor. Everyone comes together and we make the repairs. And it's usually better than it was before. So in the snakes, we don't see them either. So, I mean, it's like that.
Yeah.
Do we see many snakes? No,
not many.
She's like, what are you bringing up, the snakes?
No. Well, because my kids kill them.
Mm.
And then they bring in the house of the
snake. Then you see them. Okay.
Yeah, then I see.
But some people in other countries believe that we have snakes literally hanging from the trees.
So, what do you think, like, in what price range houses get sold quicker?
Okay, we call it the sweet spot. Because in Mobile, our average, and now everything's changing with this past year, our average last year this time was $153,000. But right now with the current market, I would say our sweet spot's going to be more like $220,000, $225,000.
Have you sold houses like half a million and higher?
Mm-hmm.
Please tell us what kind of people move down here and buy expensive properties.
Okay, well, expensive properties are a state of mind, because here our $1 million properties are something that you would probably find $500 million if you were in New York. So New York, Boston, people from the upper part of the northern regions who do have more of a disposable income and larger incomes, they're more educated. There, it's no big deal for them to have a $12 million property. So see, here, you can get a $1 or $2 million property for 10,000 square feet.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of the house you are doing an open house today? Like, this house in New York gonna be how much?
This is a 2,700 square foot house, 4 bedrooms. You have a yard that's almost an acre. You're not gonna find this in New York. If you did, it's gonna be up more toward Connecticut, and you're gonna have snow. We do not have snow here. But if you're used to snow, you want the snow, I get it. But yeah, in New York, something like this would probably be at Kenny Bunkport. I'd say 5 million.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Not only is it inexpensive to live here as far as housing, our taxes are very low here as well. It's probably some of the lowest in the country.
Some people are worried that if they come here, that they're not going to be able to find a good job. Because they think like Alabama means no jobs if everything is cheap.
Mm-hmm. My husband is in charge of hiring for one of the plants here in town, and they can't find workers. So work here is very prevalent. We have help wanted signs everywhere. We have restaurants closing down because there's no one here to work them.
Mm-hmm.
We do need workers of all scale.
Thank you.